The next topic I want to talk about is voting. Voting involves lots of cryptographic issues, and there are many interesting security properties that a voting system should provide. One property that many voting systems desire to provide is anonymity, that it shouldn't be possible for an adversary to know who someone voted for. The other property a voting system should have is that the count is verifiable. These are sort of in opposition. Verifying the count would be easy if each voter would be willing to publicly declare their vote and someone could look at all of those votes. But if we want to keep the votes anonymous and have a notion of a private ballot, well, then verifying the count becomes more challenging. Another property some voting systems want to provide is coercion resistance. What this really means is that a voter can't prove who they voted for. If votes are secret and there's no way to prove for whom one votes, well, then there's no way to coerce a voter into voting a particular way. And then we have all the usual goals of reliability and security. These things are hard to achieve. There are good ways to achieve them with paper ballots if we have trusted ballot boxes guarded by trusted election officials. And if we have enough trusted third parties, well, maybe we can trust them to report the right tally. We're going to look at one interesting cryptographic way to do voting, but I want to emphasize that this is not a solution to the real problems that are necessary to run an election. But it solves this issue of, can you keep votes anonymous and still have a way to verify that the count is correct?